Please subscribe math.com for any query, comment or email.
Hello everyone. In our today's lecture, we will see how you can find the circumference of a circle if you are given with the radius and diameter, and even if you are given with the circumference, and how you can calculate the radius or diameter or vice versa. So you have to see what are the formulas that you can use. As we have already seen in our previous lecture, the relationship between the circumference, radius and diameter. Now we will use those formulas and apply them in our problems to solve them easily. Okay, let's see what were the formulas that we must know or keep in mind in order to solve the questions where you will be asked to find the circumference of a circle. One formula is C is equals to 2 pi r, where C is the circumference and r is the radius. Another formula is C is equals to d pi. Okay, so d is here the diameter of a circle, d is here the diameter, and pi is the value that is constant 3.14. You can also write it as pi is equal to 3.14 or 22/7. And another formula is d is equals to 2r. It's also very important so that you can easily calculate if you are given with the radius, or if you are given with the diameter, you can calculate the radius and vice. Okay, these are the three formulas that you have to keep in your mind in order to find out the circumference or radius or the diameter of a circle by using them at specific situations accordingly. Let's have some examples. Find unknown. We will see what is the unknown in the question. If pi is equals to 3.14. Now we will see what is the question actually by drawing here. This is the circle. Okay. And here the radius is 2.6 centimeter and the diameter is unknown, and the dotted line will show the circumference and it is also unknown. Now let's see how you can solve the questions like. Okay, first of all we'll write what is given, what is known and what is unknown. We'll start from the diameter. Diameter is equals to d is equals to, we don't know the diameter. Then the circumference is equal to c, we don't know the circumference, and what is known here is the radius. We just know the value of radius, that is 2.6 centimeter. Let's see how you can solve it out. First we will see what were the formulas. We have to recall them in our mind, or we can write it them on aside. We were having the formulas. These are the three formulas that you must keep in your mind. Write them at a side and compare which formula you should use here to find out the circumference and the diameter. As we have to calculate the diameter and circumference, so we will calculate them one by one. As we have given with the radius, so we can easily find the diameter. As diameter is 2 times the radius, it means we can easily find the diameter. So d is equals to 2r. 2 into r is 2.6 centimeter, and we can have 5.2 centimeter. So the value of the diameter comes out 5.2 centimeter. That is two times the radius. Okay. Now thus what left is circumference. Now let's see which formula we can use, as now we have diameter as well as radius. We can use this formula as well as this formula. As the second formula is short, we can use this because we have pi as well as we have diameter now. So we can write it as circumference is equals to d pi. What is d? D is 5.2 centimeter that we have calculated right now, into 3.14, the value of pi. So 5.2 into 3.14 gives us 16.32. So this is the value of the circumference. So this is how you can calculate the circumference and diameter if you are given with the radius. Let's have one more example where you will be asked to calculate the diameter and radius, and the given will be the circumference. So this is the circle, this is the central point, here comes the radius, this will be the diameter and this will be the circumference. In this example, We don't know what is the value of diameter. We don't know what is the value of radius. We just know the value of circumference. That is equals to 23.3 centimeters. Let's see how you handle such problems. First, we'll write the known and unknown quantities. Diameter is equals, it is unknown. Then radius equals to, this is also unknown. Then the circumference. This is the known, only known quantity here. That is 23.3 centimeters. Let's revise our formulas aside that are okay. So these were the three formulas. First, we will see which formula we can use in which we can apply by applying where we can apply the value of circumference. Okay, here in this we can use the first two formulas in order to find our required quantity, either radius or diameter. Okay, because in formula one, you can see circumference is given 2 into pi. Pi is also known and radius can be calculated from here. And in formula 2, C is given, pi is given, D can be calculated. So we will use the formula 2, that is a little bit easy to cater our problems. C is equals to D pi. Okay. C is equals to D pi. And what we have to find out here, we have to find the diameter. So we will divide d on both sides. We will divide pi on both sides. Then what we will get is d is equals to c over pi. Okay. Now we will put the values as c. Value of c is 23.3. Pi is 3.14, and it will give you the d. So the value that will come out by 3.14 is 7.42. Okay, so this will be the value of diameter. So once you get the value of diameter, you can easily find out the value of radius, that is the half of diameter. Okay, so radius will be the half of diameter. So value of diameter is 7.42 over 2. You will get 3.71 centimeters. So this is the value of radius. So it is clear from here that if even if you are given with the value of circumference, you can easily calculate the value of diameter and radius. Let's have one more example in which you will be given with the diameter and you have to calculate the radius and circumference. Let's draw the circle. Let's draw its diameter. Diameter is equals to 11 centimeter. Okay, its radius is unknown and its circumference is also unknown. This is the circumference and this is also unknown. Let's see how you will go through such examples. Okay, you will be given with the diameter, that is equals to 11 centimeter. You don't know the radius, you don't know the circumference, and you just have to calculate the both these things from radius, from diameter. Okay, let's find it out. As diameter, as radius is half of diameter, we can calculate the radius from this expression. From this concept, you must have the concept that radius is half of the diameter. Okay, so we have given with diameter value, that is 11 centimeter divided by 2 to give you 5.5 centimeter. This is the value of radius diameter. So c is equals to pi d will be used. That is simple one. Pi, value of pi is 3.14 considered here. Multiplied the value of d is 11. 34.54 centimeters. So this is the value of circumference. So this is all about how you can solve the problems related to diameter, circumference and radius, and how they are interrelated to each other, and how you can calculate the one quantity from the other. Thank you
for watching. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe our channel math.com for more updates. Thank you.